Equal, rejects greed and avarice, you know. He respects all women, yes he does, as he respects his own mother, yes, because
truth, satya, implies love, and firmness, agreh, engenders and therefore serves as a synonym for force. I thus began to call the Indian movement Satyagraha, that is to say, the force that is born of truth and love or non-violence, and gave up the use of the phrase passive resistance in connection with it. So much so that even in English writing we often avoided it and used instead Satyagraha.
Gandhi was actually conferred the title of Mahatma by Rabindranath. Right? And the word Mahatma, in fact, is a very lofty word because it just doesn't mean the great soul, which is the ordinary English translation of Mahatma, but it means someone who's enlightened. And I think Tagore very early came to the realization that there was something exceptional about this man. In fact, when you call a person a Mahatma, in part, what it means is you have taken him out of the fold of the family and placed him within the larger ambit of the citizenry of the country. It was said at that time, right, by people like Einstein and many others, that Gandhi belongs to the ages, right? I mean, not just to India, not just to the world, but he belongs to the ages.
Would you like to be like Gandhi?
Maybe.
I think it's very hard to be like he was. I think he was a great man. And I think he taught many people to fight for their rights in a peaceful way. And that's what we like so much about him.
Do you think Gandhi is relevant in today's world?
I think so, because I feel that if I do something big one day, I will do it his way. His way of non-violence. And I think that is the most intelligent and powerful way to guide the world.
If Gandhi was alive today, how would you reinvent him to be more acceptable to the young generation?
I don't think anybody would have required to reinvent Bapu, because Bapu would have been reinventing himself periodically. The man who lived a life of experimentation would never have stagnated. So he would have reinvented himself as times changed.
During the Satyagraha in South Africa, I had altered my style of dress so as to make it more in keeping with that of indentured laborers. And in England also, I adhered to the same style for indoor use. For landing in Bombay, I had a Kathiawadi suit of clothes, consisting of a shirt, a dhoti, a cloak, and a white scarf, all made of Indian mill cloth.
Let's discuss what Gandhi is.
So we'll do the brainstorming first.
Yeah, we can do that.
He said quit India because, you know, he would concentrate on these Indian business people like the Birlas, Tatas, and the Bajaj.
And again, where he see that the slogan he has taken,
yes,
the coin,
quit
the
India.
Term that he coined. Definitely.
So he said like quit India for the foreign investment, and he could promote these Indian businessmen so that they can have their own economy.
And he also did promote India.
Yes.
If you see, India he promoted in his own way. And the khadi, the salt, it was just a business thing.
It was purely business.
Yeah.
If we see Gandhi, when he was in India, before he went to England, he was dressed as a traditional baniya, how they dressed. When he went to England to study there, he changed himself. he thought that, you know, the Western people cannot accept him. So maybe he dressed accordingly so that he could at least say hi, hello to them.
He underdressed because he had to appeal to masses. And at that time, that particular time, the people, the masses consisted of poor and people who were underprivileged. So he had to be with them. Same philosophy, we have put it in our design. The clothes that we have taken and the details we have put in. It has to appeal the masses, yet it has to appeal masses as well as the classes, we can say.
So I don't want to kill the DNA of Gandhi's look, whether it's a watch or the glasses. We have given him the look of a business leader, where it's more of a corporate look. The trouser is inspired by the dhoti.
And I would like dress up in a traveler thing, because he has to be a youth icon as well. We cannot forget youth at all. And if we see the trousers, they are Jodhpuri trousers. Jodhpuri, again, it has a relation with royalty. And then I'll also give him Apple, yeah. iPad.
Tablet. Yes.
Because he always used to carry Bhagavad Gita.
Yeah.
But now it can be in an e-book.
Mm-hmm.
To just go in sync with the youth.
I believed at the time of which I'm writing that in order to look civilized, our dress and manners has as far as possible to approximate to the European standard. Because I thought only thus could we have some influence. And without influence, it would not be possible to serve the community. I therefore determined the style of dress for my wife and children. How could I like them to be known as Kathiyawadi Baniyas? The Parsis used to then be regarded as the most civilized people amongst Indians. And so, when the complete European style seemed to be unsuited, we adopted the Parsi style. Accordingly, my wife wore the Parsi sari and the boys the Parsi coat and trousers.
The Gandhian view is that there is an intrinsic relationship between your own body and the body politic and the so-called inert world of nature outside. What he did, in effect, was to transform his own body into a complete ecosystem. And this is where you would have to look at how every little thing, you know, his enemas, his fasting, what he ate, what he didn't eat, what time he went to bed, what he wore, this is all part of what I call Gandhi's own ecosystem.
Mr. Chauhan, if Mahatma Gandhi were alive today, would he approve of your water business?
Definitely not. And not only Mahatma Gandhi, I think it is way before him, the Baniya community did not accept the concept of selling water. And water is something which you are supposed to give free, and you have matka outside your house from where people can take water. And if you see that in 1949, where my father started the soft drink business, he was bombarded by a whole lot of his friends saying that, "Hey, Baniya, how can you be selling water?" But to justify what I'm trying to say is we are doing a good service to the community. One, for every 1 liter of water we use, we conserve 10 liters of water by way of water harvesting. Two, we give an employment of 5,000 people. Three, if we can prevent you from getting sick for 15 rupees, will that not save you thousands of rupees of medical expense?
The earth, the air, the land, and the water are not an inheritance from our forefathers, but a loan from our children. So we have to hand over to them, at least as it was handed over to us. A country remains poor in wealth, both materially and intellectually, if it does not develop its handicrafts and its industries, and lives a lazy, parasitic life by importing all the manufactured articles from outside. There was a time when we manufactured almost all we wanted. The process is now reversed, and we are dependent upon the outside world for most manufactured goods. We do not want to follow the frog in the well policy, nor in seeming to be international, lose our roots. We cannot be international if we lose our individuality, that is, nationality.
I'm a farmer. I'm a graduate in agriculture. I am working for the foundation, National Agro Foundation, as a director. The greatest motivation is my personal satisfaction, because as a farmer, I have seen the darker side of farming or the problems of farming. But as an educator, the agriculture-based education, so I have seen the brighter side of the farming. So I thought I can make a proper blend of the technologies which can serve the farmers, and that this foundation gives me a platform to actually share this with the farmers, fellow farmers, for their betterment. So the personal satisfaction is that most motivation I have. One lead farmer, learning it, doing it, showing it to others, and then replicating to the fellow farmers. So that is the ultimate motive of our foundation. That is, from the lead farmer to a lead village to a lead district.
I had only the milk of the cow and the buffalo in mind when I took the vow. I had before me a picture of the wicked processes the cowherds adopted to extract the last drop of milk from their cows and buffaloes. Moreover, I had always held that milk is not the natural diet of man.
He is our lead farmer. Raghupathi is our lead farmer. I already told you, no? So he takes the technology and then he uses that for the welfare of the community. And he is the motivator for this village. Actually, he is a volunteer for this. He actually volunteers himself for these services for the betterment of his village. As a group in the village, they have availed the loans from the banks for getting these cows. From the income generated from the milk, they repay their loans.
You are a bachelor?
Yes, I am a bachelor.
Why?
Because I want to serve the service to the villages. If I am a married fellow, I just not able to serve for the others. So not only that's the reason, but it is.
You've got such a beautiful house.
No, for your view it may be a beautiful house. But in my view it is not a beautiful house. Because I also want to live luxury. But I cannot be able to live like Chennai people or other incoming peoples.
Why are there no young people? They don't like living in village?
Yes, because here the earnings are too low. In Chennai, in industrial work, they earn per day 300 rupees. But here, although we work hard for 24 hours in agriculture, we cannot get 300 rupees per day. So we can average, we can pay 50 to 100 rupees. It is also not stable to us. So they want to migrate to the outer places, and they are going and earning money. Sir.
Today, Mr. Raghupathi, if someone came and said, I give you a lot of money for your land, will you sell?
No, we won't sell, because it is our mother. Land is just like our mother. We cannot sell it. We will enjoy it still in future also. We will never sell it. So we want to live here, we want to earn here, we want to die here.
What do you know about Mahatma Gandhi?
he served for the nation without any expectations. He want to grow the villages. So, I know something about that.
What about young people? Do they want to learn about Mahatma Gandhi?
No. They don't want that. If we say them about Mahatma, you go. It is our ancient period. Now we want the computer period. No, we don't want to learn about Gandhi. Yes, some of them are saying.
What is the aim of National Agro Foundation?
My father called it as the second green revolution, which he said the objective is to make sure that the migration should be stemmed. For that, agriculture should be made viable so that we have no more slums, which is crowding over, because there is less land available now for agriculture because, you know, the main reason, according to me, is the causes are the population, pollution and poverty. And to overcome that, a second green revolution came into this thing. That's National Agro Foundation's role or objective is to make sure that the purchasing power of the farmers has to go up. Gandhiji and father, why I relate to them was they were all not, they were not looking at the next election. They were looking at the next generation. That's the most important thing, the next generation. Look at the future. Why should a man at the age of 90, when he starts the National Agro Foundation to bring about the second green revolution, he wanted to do more and more. And it's like a relay race. You'll have to, somebody takes the baton and runs. And it hands it over to the next person, and that's how it should go on. In India, far too long, we have built individuals. You have to build institutions. And it should be, you know, people should come and take over. I think that is all the, these are some of the learned essence of Gandhiji's teachings, which are relevant even today.
There is an art that kills and an art that gives life. The fine fabric that we import from the West or the Far East has literally killed millions of our brothers and sisters and delivered thousands of our dear sisters to a life of shame. True art must be evidence of happiness, contentment and purity of its authors. And if you will have such art revived in our midst, the use of khadi is obligatory. On the best of you at the present moment. If India is to attain true freedom, then sooner or later the fact must be recognized that people will have to live in villages, not in towns, in huts, not in palaces. I do believe that the yarn we spin is capable of mending the broken warp and roof of our life.
Okay.
I want to be an engineer.
You don't want to learn weaving?
No, ma'am. I can't because I know how tough work it is. In previous days, there is a lot of people are trying to do this thing. And in those days, all are working to the urban areas. And, it's not possible to do this thing in the future, I think.
But don't you want to learn this art from your father? He's an artist.
Yeah, something I know. I don't know exactly full and fully. So I don't like to know about it. My dad deserves it. It's end with me. No need to for my son and my future generation.
Four members maintaining. For month, 3,000 incoming.
Gandhigram was started more or less at the suggestion of Mahatma Gandhi himself, probably. See, the history goes back to death of Kasturba. She died in 22nd February 1944. Soon after, a Kasturba Trust was created and Mahatma Gandhi himself was the chairman with Sarojini Naidu as the treasurer. Even in those days, they collected more than 1 crore. And then Gandhi decided that it should be given to responsible people in different states of the country to start some welfare activities for women and children. And one condition which Gandhiji had put was that it should be at least 7 miles away from the nearest town. That way our founder, Dr. Soundaram, who was personally known to him, was selected as Pratinidhi or agent for Tamil Nadu. She was a child widow. She was probably married when she was 9 or 10 and she became widow at the age of 12, 13.
What is your profit from Lijjat Papad?
We provide employment opportunities from 60, 70 women and they earn a lot, you know, depending upon the input of labor. They may be making for 150, 200 rupees very easily.
What are your future plans for the Gandhigram Trust?
Future plans means first, you know, keeping the existing thing, that itself is a challenge. But future means, because the thanks we have got now 1,000 self-help groups of women who think sky is not the limit, they want to do many things. This is the Gandhian philosophy we are following. Gandhian philosophy, basically, you know, every village should be self-sufficient. Employment opportunities should be created in the villages. So that is where whatever we have is a replicable model of village industry, how it can be run successfully. We cannot go for a large scale.
பண்ணிட்டே இருக்கேன். And now, after considerable experience with many public institutions which I have managed, it has become my firm conviction that institutions maintained on permanent funds are often found to ignore public opinion and are frequently responsible for acts contrary to it. It is the duty of a nature cure doctor not only to look after the body, but also pay attention to and prescribe for the soul of the patient. Whatever the apparent cause of fever, the real cause in every case is one and the same, that is, accumulation of waste matter in the intestines. Science has not so far discovered any recipe for making the body immortal. Immortality is an attribute of the soul.
கொஞ்சம் கஷ்டத்தில் பணம் கடன் தொல்லையில் இருந்தேன். அந்த கடனுக்காக ஊரை விட்டே போகிற மாதிரி இருந்தேன். அப்புறம் குழுவில் சேர்ந்து இங்கே கேன்டீன் நடத்துறதுக்கு ஆள் இல்லைன்னு சொல்லி கூப்பிட்டாங்க. அப்படியே கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சமாக இதிலேருந்து சம்பாரித்து கடன் கட்டினேன். கடன் கட்டிட்டு இப்போ கொஞ்சம் ரொம்ப நல்லா இருக்கிறேன். ஒரு நாளைக்கு எவ்வளோன்னு சொல்ல முடியாதியா? இப்போ உங்களும் இப்போலாம் கெஸ்ட் நிறையா வந்திருக்காங்க. இப்படி ஆள் வந்தாங்கன்னா ஒரு நாளைக்கு இப்போ 2000-3000 போடுச்சுன்னா 1500 தான் கிடைக்கும். நாங்கள் வந்து கம்மியான பில் தான் போடுறோம், அதனால் ஒரு 500 கிடைக்கும். காந்தியை பற்றி சொல்கிறதை பற்றி தெரிஞ்சுக்கிறது, அப்புறம் அவரை பற்றி நமக்கு தெரியாதுல்ல. காந்தி கிராமம்னா மட்டன் சிக்கன் சாப்பிடக்கூடாது, அது இங்கே போடக்கூடாதுன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க.
மை அஹிம்சா வுட் நாட் டாலரேட் தி ஐடியா ஆஃப் கிவிங் அ ஃப்ரீ மீல் டு அ ஹெல்த்தி பர்சன் ஹூ ஹஸ் நாட் ஒர்க்ட் ஃபார் இட் இன் சம் ஆனஸ்ட் வே. A customer is the most important visitor on our premises. He is not dependent on us, we are dependent on him. He is not an interruption in our work, he is the purpose of it. He is not an outsider in our business, he is part of it. We are not doing him a favor by serving him. He is doing us a favor by giving us an opportunity to do so. To my mind, the life of a lamb is no less precious than that of a human being. I should be unwilling to take the life of a lamb for the sake of the human body. I hold that the more helpless a creature, the more entitled it is to protection by men from the cruelty of man. The idol in the temple is not God, but since God resides in every atom, he resides in an idol. God is an unchanging law. Normally by law, we understand what is prescribed in the religious text. But here what I am talking about is an eternal principle which does not change with change in circumstances. This is the truth, and that is why I say that truth is God.
भजन तो तेने पहिए वैष्णव भजन तो तेने कहिए पीर पराई जाने वैष्णव भजन तो
कौन सा है महात्मा गांधी? वो कौन है महात्मा गांधी
जो पैसों में थे
पैसे बनाता है
पीर पराई
उनके जैसे है कोई नहीं, लेकिन थोड़ा सा जो अन्ना हजारे लड़ रहे हैं उनमें थोड़ा उनके थोड़ा सा स्वभाव दिखता है।
Do you think Mahatma Gandhi is relevant in India today?
Well, if truth, love and peace and non-violence as a corollary or as the fountain of peace are important to civilization, then he will always remain relevant. Because as he said in his own words, truth, peace and non-violence were as old as the rivers and the mountains, and he had not invented them. And so as long as those are important for the existence of humanity, he will always be relevant.
हाँ वही चाहिए।
I learned the true practice of law. I had learned to find out the better side of human nature and to enter men's hearts. I realized that the true function of a lawyer was to unite parties riven asunder. The lesson was so indelibly burnt into me that a large part of my time during the 20 years of my practice as a lawyer was occupied in bringing about private compromises of hundreds of cases. I lost nothing thereby, not even money, certainly not my soul.
हमारा जो काम है वो आपके लिए कुछ डिसाइड करना नहीं है. वी डोंट डिसाइड फॉर यू. व्हाट वी डू इज वी पुट यू टुगेदर एंड टेक बोथ योर ओपिनियंस एंड हेल्प यू एंड फैसिलिटेट यू. आपकी मदद करते हैं कि आप डिसीजन पे आए और इमिकेबली सेटलमेंट हो जाए. अच्छा, आप फिल्म फाइनेंसर हैं?
जी,
और
प्रोड्यूसर.
ओके.
The Delhi High Court in May 2006 inaugurated the Mediation and Conciliation Center. Do you think it has been beneficial to client and lawyer both?
It is beneficial to both. It has brought about a change in the legal fraternity who is connected with the Mediation Center. It has brought about a sense within the, a confidence sense within the litigants that a lawyer can also be a facilitator to settle the matters. It has also brought about a satisfaction with a litigant to say, my case can be settled at an early date with the intervention of the lawyer.
He can't just say, I'll return the principal or a minimal interest.
What is the mediator's fee?
We are not paying him, we are not compensating him for the time that he's putting in, because most of us does this work pro bono. The purpose is to change the image of the legal fraternity in the minds of people.
So the lawyers, I would say, says, let if the clients are agreeable to 12%, let's go with it.
Yes, okay, let's go with that 12%. If he's, but 12% only if he returns it in 6 months. 18% even a day after that.
What do you say,
fair,
Mr. Mitra?
Fair enough, ma'am.
Both of you want to share hands? Yeah. So hopefully now you've had a good agreement and you will be able to take loan from me for your next film. Instead of going to court, right?
Sir, 5 please. 6 or 5?
In your opinion, was Gandhi a good lawyer?
I call him a good lawyer because, as I said, lawyer is a profession to ensure peace, harmony, goodness in the society. And the fact that Gandhiji was able to do that, I call him an excellent lawyer.
There is no such thing as Gandhiism, and I do not want to leave any sect after me. Was it that you wanted to pull my leg, transporting me to the frozen Himalayan heights of Mahatmaship, and claiming for yourself absolution from having to follow my precepts?